this was clearly worth something. Some things were worthless junk, but this could be sold for a decent price.
Thank you.
I was able to salvage some circuitry from the other robot, and Heather was more than happy to help fit it. Heather showed me her robot manual and explained how I would use this new power-up. It was designed for demolition units and seemed that it reinforced my shoulders, allowing me to barge through old or crumbling walls. The controllers relied on a press of either of the shoulder buttons to activate the dash and subsequent wall smash. Just like the last satellite part, this one looked like it would explode in 10 minutes. I needed to get back to the hallway. Upon my return, the old lady and the blind man fitted the circuitry. I was worried about Mr. Deck as he seemed depressed about being chained up. But when I tried to talk to him, he just looked angry and went back to his lovely music. So I made my way up to the roof to help everyone fit the satellite dish, and bring us one step closer to broadcasting the nice virus. With some brilliant timing, as we all climbed down from the roof, the professor appeared. I think this was the youngest I had ever seen him. Mr. Preston looked most shocked. When we last saw you, you were, but the professor cut him off explaining, "Stop, I can't risk my mission by knowing too much about my personal future." Mr. Deck was so pleased to see him, saying, "Thank God you're back, it's terrible here with these savages." When we explained what we were trying to do, the professor seemed pleased and offered to help. Somehow his box opened some kind of portal and he urged me to step through. I was slightly apprehensive but followed him into what turned out to be his bedroom. He explained that now I would be able to travel instantly between the hallway and his room, which, when he showed me on my map, turned out to be really useful. So, after he had undone the complicated looking lock on the door, we made our way back to the hallway. But before we could even thank him, he was gone again. "Hello Japan, this is Nighthawk calling," said Heather. "Are you receiving me? Over." 4 days we'd all taken it in turns trying to contact Dr. Hero, but the longer it went on the less hopeful we were. "Any luck?" asked Sim. "No, nothing," said Heather. "I'm just worried they're all dead." I didn't like having that image in my mind. If there's one thing I'd learnt, it was that death is really sad. Now then, this is nice. I've ordered. Everything else is junk. Go on.
Oh.